have created a couple of Microsoft Fabric items, but I do not know where to go to find and modify the connections. These Fabric items include semantic models, Dataflows Gen 1, Dataflows Gen 2, and others. Hi, I'm Sohail Bakhshi, a Microsoft Data Platform MVP, with a very warm welcome from biinsight.com, and I'm glad to have you here today. In Microsoft Fabric, a data connection refers to the link between the platform and various types of data stores, whether cloud sources or on-premises. Let us see which items on Microsoft Fabric create data connections. The data connections indeed are created by various items in Microsoft Fabric, such as Data Factory Pipelines, Dataflows Gen 1, Dataflows Gen 2, Paginated Reports, Semantic Models, KQL Databases, and Mirror Azure SQL Databases, which is currently in preview. These are the current items that create data connections. Who knows, in the future, there might be some more items that create data connections. Now the question is, where are these data connections in Microsoft Fabric? Let's have a look at it in a demo. Now let's see how we can find and manage data connections in Microsoft Fabric. To get to the data connections in Microsoft Fabric, we need to click on the gear icon on top right of the page and then select Manage Connections and Gateways. The first tab on this page is Connections, and that is exactly what we are after. We can also manage on-premises data gateways and virtual networks, but those are out of the context of today's video. Under the Connections tab, we can see all the connections that are shared with us or we have created before. From here, we can click on the Check Status button on every single connection to get the updated status of the connection. And some of these connections are offline and they are not even accessible. As you can see, I have a connection here with the gateway cluster in personal mode. This is something that has been generated a long time ago and this folder doesn't exist anymore. So from here, I can click on the ellipsis button and remove a connection. If it is an old connection and I'm not using it, why it should be here? So I click on remove to remove that connection. By toggling data administration on, a managed cloud connection sharing option also appears on top here. Let's have a look at Manage Cloud Connection Sharing option. From here, we can restrict users in our organization to share cloud connections by toggling this option on or off. Then I can click on the Confirm Policy to confirm my policy, or I can toggle it on and specify who across the organization can share cloud connections. In my example, I have a security group called Fabric Governance Group that I would like to give these people the ability to share connections across the organization. After adding this security group, I click Confirm Policy. I hear you ask, so what? What is this cloud connection sharing? Let's have a look. Let's open another user. This is Nestor, which is another user in my tenant. And let's see what Nestor can see. Let's click on the setting and then go Manage Connections and Gateways. Here are the connections that Nestor can see. This one is the connection that we have created earlier and is available across the organization. Now let's see if Nestor can share a connection with others. To do so, he has to click on the ellipse button and then click Manage Users. And then from here, you can see that he doesn't have access to sharing connection with others. If Nestor was a member of the Fabric Governance Group, he could share this connection with others, but now he cannot. Let's see how we can share a connection with Nestor. Let's switch back to our admin user. And from here, I want to share ADLS Gen 2 connection with Nestor. I click on the ellipse button and click Manage Users. And from there, I find Nestor's account and add him in. Now, I want to define what Nestor can do with the connection after it is shared with him. While Nestor is not a member of my governance group, which had cloud sharing capabilities, it doesn't make sense to add Nestor as a user with reshare. So I just go ahead and share it with him as a user. That's all done. Now let's switch back to Nestor's account and let's refresh the page and see if Nestor can actually access the ADLS Gen 2 connection that we shared with him. Yes, as you can see, he now can access the connection that is shared with him. Now let's see how we can create a new connection. Okay, now let's create a new connection. I click on the new button. I click on cloud because this is a cloud connection that I want to make. I want to grab your attention for a second. Let's read through the warning on top, which says currently cloud connections are not supported by Dataflows, Dataflows Gen 2 and Datamarts. So let's be aware of that. Now let's create a connection, give it a new name, and the connection type is SQL Server, because I'm going to connect to an Azure SQL database and my database is AdventureWorks 2019. Authentication method, I would select basic for now. Then I enter my username and password and then I click the create button. After a second or so, as you can see, the connection is created. Now let's see how we can reuse the connection. Let's head over to my workspace and create a new Dataflows Gen 1. If you recall, Dataflows Gen 1, Gen 2, and Datamarts cannot reuse connections, but let's have a look and see how it works in practice. I want to connect to my Azure SQL database that I created the connection before. As you can see on their connections, it says create new connection, which means the created connection is not available. Let's hit the refresh button and check it again. It still says create a new connection. Let's put the server name and database name to see if it makes a difference. As you can see, it doesn't make any difference. So that is not going to work on Dataflows Gen 1 and Datamarts. Let's head over to my workspace and try another item. I am under Power BI experience now. Let's create new data pipeline. I click more options. I click on the data pipeline. I stick to the default name and I click create. Click pipeline activity, then click copy data. And from here, we want to configure the source. Click on the source. And then data store type is external. As you can see, the connection appears here, Azure SQL database, which is the one that we created earlier. The only remaining part is to select the connection type and set it to Azure SQL database. It already identified the rest of the configuration. That's pretty much it. Please let me know if you have used connections in Microsoft Fabric before, if you have configured them, if you have shared them with others across the organization. And I hope you enjoyed this video and you have learned something new. Catch you in the next one.